Good evening students. In the last class, we have discussed about different types of multiple access control protocol. Today, we will going to discuss one of the random access control protocol, that is Aloha protocol. The Aloha protocol is developed by University of Hawaii in earlier 1970. It is basically designed for a radio or wireless LAN, but on shared medium it can be used. The Aloha protocol is further divided into two types. One is pure Aloha and another one is slotted Aloha. So first we will know that what is pure Aloha. In pure Aloha, a sender station will send a frame to receiver stations and it will wait for the acknowledgement. So it can send the data in any time given in the channel. There is no time restrictions for the stations. Okay, so see here the flowchart of pure Aloha. Suppose A wants to send frame to B, it will start, and first we will initialize a back off to 0. Then we will send a frame, wait for the acknowledgement at a specified time. If the acknowledgement has been received, then the communication will be success. If not, then we will increase the back off, which is set here. We will increase the back off and again we will check for the condition, that is the back off limit has been exceeded or not. If exceeded, then we will abort the communication. If not, we will wait for random amount of time, then we will again send the frame. So here in the pure Aloha, there is the chances of collision. So it will not decrease the chances of collision. See here, if A, B, C are the three stations, they can send data anytime, right? So there is a chances of collision. So one here also collision and here also collision. To avoid this collision or to decrease the amount of collision, we will go for slotted Aloha. So in slotted Aloha, it divides the time of shared channels to decrease intervals called as time slots. So any station can transmit its data in any time slot, but the condition is the station must start its transmission from the transmission of data from the beginning of the time slots. If the beginning of the time slots is missed, then the station has to wait until the beginning of the next slot. Okay, a collision may occur if two or more station try to transmit the data at the beginning of the same slot. So see here, here also there is a chances of collision and here is also there is a chances of collision. But compared to pure Aloha, the slotted Aloha reduces the collision time or collision amount to half, right? So this is about Aloha protocol. So hope you all understand. In the next video, we will discuss about the CSMA protocol. Thank you.